get your sheet.
Welcome, everybody, to the December 16th, 2010 City of Franklin Planning Commission meeting. Thanks, everybody, for being here. At least we're not trudging through the snow tonight to get here. Let's start with the minutes of the meeting from November. Is there a motion?
Move for approval.
Second.
Okay. Any comments relative to the minutes before we vote? All right. Seeing none, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The ayes have it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you have items you'd like to discuss with the commission that are non-agenda items tonight, we open the floor to you right now. Otherwise, we'll move on. Okay, let's move on. Catherine, any announcements for the night?
No, sir.
All right, then let's move on. Any non-agenda items? I've not been made aware of anything, but okay. Then we'll move on to the consent agenda. All right, folks, we have right now three items that are on non-consent. If anybody in the audience, on the staff or the commission would like to pull an item from the consent, and then and those items right now on consent are 9, 10, 11, and 12. So anybody wants to pull an item? All right, I see none. Then is there a motion?
Move for approval, consent agenda.
Okay.
I need to be recused from voting on this item.
All right, that's great.
Second, then.
Moved and seconded. All right, any comments? All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The ayes have it. We will then move to item number 7, Resolution 2010-87, a resolution approving a regulating plan for Eddie Thompson PUD subdivision, 5 dwelling units are on 0.7 acres, located along Eddie Lane between Glenco Court and Lucinda Court by the City of Franklin, Tennessee.
Mr. Chairman, the rezoning and concept plan for this subdivision were approved earlier this year. September 28th is when the concept plan was approved, and then the rezoning was approved on October 12th by BOMA. The regulating plan matches the concept plan exactly. It proposes 3 lots. 2 of the lots currently have 2 duplexes, so a total of 4 units on them. And then the applicant is proposing to subdivide a separate lot that is just slightly smaller than the lots that continue down the road. And that concept plan has been approved, so staff recommends approval of the regulating plan, but not just that.
Okay, thank you. Is there anyone in the audience that wants to speak to this item? All right, seeing none, is there someone representing the applicant? Okay, seeing none, then we'll move on to a motion.
Move for approval.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? The ayes have it. All right, the next item, I'm going to recuse myself and ask our Vice Chairman Roger to take that over, please.
Okay, item number 8 is Resolution 2010-88, a resolution approving a regulating plan for McEwen Place PUD subdivision, sections 1 and 2, 370 dwelling units, and 285,554 non-residential square feet on 48.11 acres, located along West McEwen Drive by the City of Franklin, Tennessee.
The concept plan for this subdivision was last revised in March of 2009. This regulating plan is just for 2 sections of the subdivision, mainly what is south of McEwen Drive, and then the existing apartments, the dwell apartments, and then a parcel just south of that. The entitlements for the property are not changing with this regulating plan, but the main difference is that this regulating plan replaces a previously proposed attached residential or mixed-use building that was located just west of the Whole Foods building, and then it also replaces the hotel with a one-story restaurant retail building. So both of those components that were previously proposed are now being replaced with retail and restaurant one-story buildings. Staff recommends approval of the regulating plan.
Okay, thank you. Is there anyone from the public that would like to address this item? Would you come, can you come to the lectern and give your name and address, please?
My name is Anita Cochran. I live at 1876 Wilson Pike. I live just down the street from McEwen, and I've been a resident there for almost 11 years. And some of my neighbors, I think, just pulled in. But we are very concerned about this area. We live there. We love it. And
this, I think you're
in the wrong.
This is the other end of the queue.
Sorry. That's okay. Is there anyone else from the public that would like to address this item? Okay, is there someone from the owner that would like to address the commission, please? Thanks, Doug.
Good evening. My name is Doug Sharp. I'm with Southern Land Company, and this evening we're talking about McEwen Place, PUD subdivision on West McEwen Drive. As staff has pointed out, this is a partial regulating plan for the development of some 90 acres total. This covers about 45% of the ground. And still leaves after this, still in the balance, some 61% of the residential entitlements for future sections or for future potential infill within what we're already proposing. And also some 75% of the commercial entitlements, as well as the entitlements remaining for the hotel as well. So this is a very exciting but still an incremental step in the overall community. We are asking your approval this evening and our agreement with the staff conditions.
Mr. Vice Chairman, I would like to add one thing, or actually two things. There were some staff report recommendations that were revised earlier this week that you should have received. Staff is recommending that the condition of approval number 10 be revised to state the applicant shall show the sidewalk per discussions with city staff along the frontage of the bank site along McEwen Drive. And then we'd also like to add another project consideration to state that a regulating plan for section 3 shall be submitted and approved prior to the issuance of any grading permit for infrastructure in section 3. Also, the applicant has requested a modification of design standards for the length of the attached residential buildings on proposed lot 104. Their modification of standards specifically requests that the attached residential structure not exceed 220 feet. And since the blocks are already existing and the streets have been planned and approved with the concept plan, staff has agreed with the applicant and would recommend that Planning Commission approve this modification of standards.
Okay, thanks. And just for clarification, Doug, your agreement to staff comments addresses is consistent with these additional comments?
Yes, sir, we are.
Okay. Do we have a motion on this item?
Move for approval.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion?
This is with the revised comments.
Yes,
revised. Hearing no other discussion, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, nay. Motion passes unanimously.
Thank you.
Thank you, Roger. Okay, we move on to item number 13. This is discussion about amending the Seward Hall character area section of the Franklin land use plan. Anita, this will be for you.
This proposed plan update was discussed in great detail at the November Joint Conceptual Workshop. Based on those conversations, staff has gone ahead and revised the limits and recommendations for Special Area 7, which is showing up on the screen now, which allows for a potential of small-scale commercial development, small-scale commercial uses east of Wilson Pike, and only if and when McEwen Pike goes through that intersection. I believe there are a number of individuals here tonight, as well as out in the community, that would like that special area to be removed. Staff is still recommending that stay, just because it best balances out some best planning practices, as well as we hope through the different conditions that we put in there, still addresses some of the community's needs.
Okay, thank you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is an opportunity for us to hear from you. If you'll come forward and tell us your name, where you live, and you've got 2 minutes. And if you'll notice, we've got some new technology. Up on the screen in the corner on these three walls, it says timer. That kind of gives you an idea of where you stand relative to the 2 minutes. So.
Pressure. Good evening. My name is Kate Gallagher. I reside at 521 Federal Street in the city of Franklin. Thank you for the opportunity to speak this evening. My husband and I do not believe that we need an activity center at the intersection of McEwen and Wilson Pike. We already have sufficient commercial property located near our community that has not been utilized. For example, in McKay's Mill at the intersection of Liberty Pike and Oxford Glen, there is commercial property on three corners. One entire building is empty. Public shopping plaza area, there are 5 retail shops that are currently empty. And in the McKay's Mill Dental and Vet building, there are 2 retail shops currently empty. This space is located in the heart of a residential neighborhood, and yet it remains empty. Do we really want more empty storefronts in our community? In addition to the already available retail in McKay's Mill, we have plenty of shopping in Cool Springs, Moores Lane, and on Route 96 and Murfreesboro Road. We moved to this area of Franklin for the rural, beautiful setting of the area. We do not believe that an activity center will be in keeping with the character of our community. Please do not ruin the beauty of our home. We respectfully ask that you amend the Seward Hall character area update to remove the activity center commercial rezoning from the corner of McEwen and Wilson Pike. And I personally would like to thank Aaron for listening to our concerns and the Planning Commission for holding the session at the firehouse. It was really very helpful, especially to a new neighbor and a new resident of the city of Franklin. So thank you. Happy holidays. Kate and Dennis Gallagher.
Thank you. Very good. You had 20 seconds to spare. That was perfect.
I don't know.
Anybody else?
She evidently doesn't.
I don't think Anita's going to come back up here.
We'd love to hear from her.
My name is Jim Weimer. My wife and I reside at 1870 Wilson Pike in the city of Franklin. We are
up to the top.
We're warm around here. Yeah, we're the one of the lots that run back that way. We live on 12 and a half acres in the city of Franklin. Absolutely love it. When we moved out here, we thought we were going to be left alone and have the deer and the antelope and whatever else roam to ourselves. And Anita Cochran next door feels the same way. I've been up here several times fighting different subdivisions that I didn't think were in the keeping with the area, and have found out that the folks that are in Chardonnay and what's the other one, Breezeway, that they now have the same feelings that we have. You know, just please leave us alone. We don't need commercial development out there. We've got plenty of commercial development. This gentleman that just left here looks like he's got a whole map full of things that are going to be doing over around the interstate, on the other side of the interstate when McEwen gets put through. And I know the city folks, they have these things they put together, but boy, just think of the residents for a change. We just don't need it. We don't need a Walgreens that we can walk to, or a Matco that we can drive 2 miles to, or 200 yards to. And I would appreciate if you consider the citizens. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, anyone else?
Let's try this again. I'm Anita Cochran, and I live at 1876 Wilson Pike, which is just down the street from McEwen. I moved out there approximately 11 years ago, and specifically moved on that road. I had been in love with that road for 5 years and would travel out there on my motorcycle all the time because I loved the two-lane road, the one-lane tunnels that were out there, and it was a piece of a peacefulness that you could go out to, and it was farmland. And that was specifically why I moved there. I'm an entertainer, and I like to have some property, but I don't want to be way out in past Columbia to be able to have 10 acres of property. It's peaceful. We love, all of us love where we live. We can be at 8 gas stations in a matter of 10 minutes. We can be at 6 Walgreens in a matter of 10 minutes. We can be in the middle of Cool Springs Mall in 10 minutes. We can be at every restaurant we want to be in Cool Springs in 10 minutes. We don't need anything else near us. And as they spoke earlier, there's a ton of storefronts that are sitting open that the people in McKay's Mill aren't even shopping at the Publix grocery store there. I go into that store occasionally because it's actually out of my way to go to that grocery store. And there might be 10 people in there. I mean, people aren't going to go down a country road to go find a store to shop when they have everything that they need here. And we understand that Franklin is going to grow and Cool Springs is going to grow, but this is one road that is a beautiful road that people come from miles and miles away to ride their bicycles down. We live on it. Every Saturday and Sunday, you'll see 50 bicycles in a group all riding together. Motorcycles rally down that road. Joggers run down that road. It's a place of beauty, and it's one country road kind of that we have left in Cool Springs, and we're just asking you to please leave it as it is. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, anyone else?
Hi, I'm Kathy Weber, and I live at 1900 Springcroft Drive. The only thing I want to add is what I had emailed to all of you, just to kind of like make it on public record, that it's, I'm losing the train of thought, but even if the city of Franklin were to annex everything that was warranted to them in the 1101 charter, it wouldn't be enough that would require services because your boundaries are not going to go much further east. So the people that you would be servicing in an area like this would be a small amount, like maybe a group of people like what you have in Cool Springs, at McKay's Mill. So therefore, I mean, we use Publix on the thoroughfare. A lot of people work into a metropolitan area, and they do their shopping and things on the way. It's not an area where we need services. So, and I know that's the purpose of trying to provide services for the citizens of the area, but when the citizens are saying they don't need it, it's not required, I think that should be a valid point. So that's the only thing I wanted to bring up about the charter, your UGB, where your boundaries are going to go, and how much property is actually allotted in there. You're not going to have that many residents that come in to that area when you're already at the furthest most point of your border. So thanks a lot, you know, for everybody that responded to. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Anyone else? All right, seeing none, is there a motion?
I move to approve with one amendment. And I don't know whether it's better just to take in special area 7 on page 16 to leave out under land use number 2 and development number 2, or whether just to take the whole area out.
I would recommend just taking the whole area out, and then we would probably take special area 7 and make it part of special area 4.
Yes. I wondered about that. Okay. Yes. So just to say that we would remove the special area 7 and put that property into special area 4.
Okay. Second.
All right. Moved and seconded. Any discussion?
No discussion. I would like to echo Bill Berger's comments, who is the first ward alderman. She could not be here tonight. She says she has received at least 150 emails with, I think she said, at least 148 of those against the Area 7 being an activity center and being zoned as such. So that's her comments, and she was saying the same thing that we've just got through making the motion to do, is to eliminate Area 7 as an activity center.
Thank you. Any other comments?
Especially the fact that the commercial, all of it's not even being utilized now. So there's no sense in designating more than we have used.
Okay. All right. Any other thoughts? Seeing none, then all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The ayes have it. Is that okay to just wrap that into one big motion?
And we that was your motion, right?
That was a motion.
Motion. Go ahead. Mm-hmm. Move for approval with the change.
Okay. Very good. All right, then we'll move on to adjournment then. All in favor of adjournment say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The ayes have it.